Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship at Lutheran Church of the Incarnation on this first Sunday of Christmas. It's wonderful to have you with us as we continue in this Christmas season to welcome the Christ child into our hearts. As we gather around the warmth of the manger, Christmas Eve and now Christmas Day are past, but we still gather as God's people, remembering the miracle of the Incarnation, of God's presence in our lives, in the cries of a tiny babe, in the fellowship of believers, in word and in sacrament, in our prayers, in our hope, in our love, in our connection, in the healing power of the good news. A warm welcome to you all. We pray that you're blessed and enriched by your time with us as we gather together. We thank you for your patience with us in this difficult time, continuing to stay masked over your nose and mouth as we face the Omicron variant, the COVID, this time we're living through. But we pray, hope and pray for an end to this time, and thank you for your patience in that regard. Today is Lessons and Carols, simply a time to gather together, sing and pray, and hear the stories of God's presence and God's active action in history to lift God's people and us in difficult times. So we pray that that's a blessing to you as well. We'll simply prompt you to the hymns to sing and the readings to follow as well. So I invite you to stand as you are able for the greeting. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Our prayer of the day today is from 1 Samuel. Shine into our hearts the light of your wisdom, O God, and open our minds to the knowledge of your word, that in all things we may think and act according to your good will, and may live continually in the light of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Our first reading for today is from the book of Isaiah. The people who walk in the darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy in the harvest, as people exult in dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
If you please open your hymnals, we're going to sing the first three verses of many of our traditional hymns and carols this morning. Our first one is number 269, Once in Royal David City, verses 1 through 3.
Once in Royal David City, stood This is an Old Testament reading from the prophet Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me, one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from all from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. The word of God, the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn your hymnals to number 279, O Little Town of Bethlehem. We'll sing verses 1, 2, and 4.
Of his kingdom, there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn your hymnals now to number 265, and we'll sing the first three verses of the Angel Gabriel for Heaven.
You may stand as you're able, or remain seated.
Please turn now to number 276 and sing Infant Holy and Good Hope.
Thank you. This is from Luke 2, verses 21 through 35. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male shall be designated as the holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn in your hymnals now to number 296 as we sing "What Child Is This?"
What child is this?
This is a New Testament reading from Matthew. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time that the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for this child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star that they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you're able for our next hymn.
Our next song, "We Three Kings," is not actually found in the hymnal, so we're going to test your caroling. We're going to just sing the first verse. I think that's pretty familiar to most of us. So let us sing "We Three Kings." The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name,
He gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of God, the Word of life.
Thanks be to God.
You may remain standing or be seated for our next hymn.
Please turn now in your hymnals to number 295 as we sing the first three verses of The Father's Love Begun.
Remember the mark.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for those who mourn, especially the family and friends of John Drummond, our brother in Christ, especially his wife, Chris Drummond, as they mourn the loss of this great man. For all who lost their lives to COVID-19 and those who mourn them in this difficult time, Lord, we pray for comfort and peace in this holiday season. Lord, in your mercy. We lift up those who celebrate birthdays in the coming week and pray for a special measure of blessing upon them in the coming year. For Laura Kramer and Karen Sleekert, especially from our congregation. And for David and Molly Anderson and Becky and Carl Lindwell, celebrating anniversaries in the coming week. Lord, in your mercy. We pray all these things in the name of the one who meets us in the manger, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share a sign of peace with one another. We have a special song for you today. This is written by Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra. It's called A Child Is Born, so it's appropriate for the Christmas season.
There's no sound.
There's a magic sound. Brass instrument getting incredibly flat when they're cold, so.
Innocent child, soft as a
Let us pray.
Gracious God, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of one who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Once again, we're gathered around the sacred meal, where Christ meets us in bread and wine as one body, where we experience healing in the good news of Jesus. As broken people, we come to be healed. In receiving bread and wine, we go to become what we have received, broken bread and poured out wine for the sake of the world. And that we are healed, we go to heal. And we remember that in the night our Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink of it for the remembrance of me." Gathered by the Spirit into one body, let us pray now as our Lord Jesus taught. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come,
your will be done
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
The gifts of God for the people of God. If you have your communion kit with you, body of Christ given for you.
Please turn to number 260.
Now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you forever in his grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Jesus Christ, host of this meal, you've given us not only this bread and cup, but your very self, that we may feast on your great love. Filled again by these signs of your grace, may we hunger for your reign of justice. May we thirst for your way of peace. For you are Lord forevermore. Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you all for joining us again. Just very, very brief announcements about our life together. It is the new year. We pray for a blessed, healthy, and safe 2022 for all of you. We're glad you're with us this Christmas season. We know it's been a difficult time. We pray for a better year next year. And we do have one announcement from our social justice chair, Ellen Collard, regarding Heart and the Cold Winter Shelter. Do you have offering baskets? Yeah, maybe we could pass the offering baskets around. That might be helpful.
Update regarding the emergency shelter at the migrant center. Sadly, they have still not rearranged things to make it safe to reopen. They're hoping to start after January, so I'm asking you to continue to sign up. I notice that people are signing up, and I'm very grateful for that. We're making great progress. If for some reason they cannot reopen, I will call each and every one of you so that you don't have to make the food. But I do think we need to plan for this because we really need those people to come out. Thank you.
Thank you, Ellen. Sure, why not? Ellen's husband, Paul.
So these are challenging times for mainline Protestant congregations all over the country and in other parts of the world. And they affect LCI as well. So in 2 weeks, Bob Kerr and I are going to host a conversation after the service about what does this mean for LCI? What are we hopeful for? What are we worried about? What questions do we have? What ideas do we have? We're also going to host a Zoom version of this for people who aren't comfortable being here in person. So I encourage you to look for announcements and to stay if you can. Thank you.
Thanks, Paul. We do have some exciting things coming in the new year, including hosting the Davis Children's Chorale. So we look forward to that and completing our sanctuary renovation. So stay tuned for those of you that are new. If you are new to our congregation for whatever reason and haven't seen you before, we do have visitor cards. We would love for you to leave some contact information so we can follow up with you to let you know a little bit more about our church community. And worship continues at 9:30 on Sunday mornings, and we have education at 10:30 on an ongoing basis. Once again, it's been wonderful to have you all with us in worship this morning for lessons and carols. Make sure I haven't forgotten anything here. And I invite you to stand with me as you're able. For the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Please open your hymnals now to number 267 and let us sing all four verses of joy to the world. 267.